Hello friends, in this video we will try to understand the basics of MPEG algorithm after studying the compression technique along with the JPEG algorithm. So basically, what it means by MPEG algorithm? MPEG is a motion picture expert group. Is used for encoding the videos, movies or motion pictures. Now we are able to use JPEG also for the image compression purpose. Then why we are moving for the MPEG? The simple answer is to overcome the drawback which we get from the JPEG, and it can be possible by using the MPEG. But the most probably we go for MPEG only because of one more thing, that is nothing but it is used for the encoding videos, movies and especially the motion pictures. What it means by the video or the motion picture? JPEG is a technique which we can use for the image compression. This we have already studied. And its algorithm is also very simple, which we can apply on the different parts of the image to get a better result. But though we are having JPEG in our hand, we move for MPEG only because MPEG will do the encoding of video, means what? Sequence of images at one time. That means a video is nothing but what? A motion picture is nothing but what? Sequence of images, which can be stable, can be unstable. That means the image can be taken with the help of a single place, or it can be taken with the help of the different places. So the sequence of images and their encoding is nothing but what? Use of MPEG. Now, MPEG is a lossy video compression. We all are familiar with the lossless and the lossy type of the compression technique. Lossy means what? There will be some loss of data, actual, and this kind of data is nothing but the actual data. The meaning of compression is compressed of size, that means decrement in the size. But the meaning of lossy technique is nothing but the actual loss of data. That means this is the sender and this is our receiver, and in between that, if x is your number of message which you have to send towards your receiver, actual loss of the data will occur in the lossy technique, and hence here you are getting what? X minus N, such amount of data. So exactly what happens when you are going to use the lossy video compression? There will be the possibility of reduction in the actual data, and which is not suitable for the compression, or which is not suitable for the receiver side also, that we all know. But still we are going to use MPEG. That means here the actual loss of the data occur, but that data may not be useful or it may be the unwanted. So maximum time it will loss the data, but this particular data, we can say this can be the unwanted data. So what it means by unwanted data then? We all are familiar with a photo. That means a simple click with the help of a camera is nothing but a picture. So in that picture, we have to focus on a particular part. And a part of that particular part, though the background is blur or though the background is light in a brightness, then also it doesn't matter when we require to focus on a particular part of the image. So such kind of unwanted part, instead of that focused part, which we can do some coding or encoding on that part and which we can ignore, that particular data can be known as the unwanted data, and that data can lead to the lossy compression with the help of MPEG. So though the MPEG is nothing but the lossy video compression technique, then also we are getting the maximum good results with the help of the MPEG. Why? Because that will lose the actual data, but that data may be the unwanted data. The next part is MPEG requires continuous sequence of images to develop a video. As we have already discussed, this is the difference between the JPEG and MPEG. Joint Photographic Expert Group is nothing but JPEG, which will take one by one image. Means it will try to encode the first image, then that will be the output number one. After that, it will try to encode the second image, which may be known as the output number two, like that. But in the MPEG, input itself is nothing but the sequence of the images so that the video can develop. So development of a video is nothing but the sequence of images, and its encoding can be done with the help of the MPEG, which is known as Motion Picture Expert Group. But to encode them, it also uses the most similar technique as that of JPEG. Then why it can use the most similar technique like a JPEG? Because in the JPEG also, there will be the compression of what? Compression of image, that can be takes place. And in the MPEG also, there is a compression of what? Compression of sequence of images. So the basic component of which we have to take the compression is same, so that the encoding technique is also same or much more similar as that of JPEG for MPEG. Now, exactly what it means by MPEG file storing, because after the compression with the help of MPEG technique, we have to store the file. Like after the compression of JPEG, we can store the file like a JPG or like .jpeg. So this is nothing but what? Compression format of a file with the help of the JPEG technique. Now, with the help of MPEG, how to store the file? .mp3, .mp4. And hope we all are familiar with this kind of extension. .mp3 file is used to store the audio file format, and .mp4 file is used to store the video file format. Now, with the help of these two things, we can understand that MPEG technology is related with encoding a sequence of images, but it can store a file in the audio as well as video format. So the compression technique of MPEG can leads to store all the types of the format of the data with the help of .mp3 and with the help of .mp4 extension, so that there will be some standards of the MPEG which are suitable to store the audio files, to store the video files, and we have to see all the type of standards in detail. Now, as I already told you, the encoding technique of MPEG as well as JPEG are much more similar. Then we will have a look on the exact encoding technique with the help of MPEG algorithm. So this is nothing but the block diagram of an algorithm with the help of MPEG technology. So the first one is data development. So the first part of an MPEG algorithm is data development. Now, in the data development, there will be two main steps. The first one is formation of samples, and the second one is creation of macro balls. After creating the macro balls, its output they have to apply for the data processing unit. So the next step is nothing but data processing unit. Here again, there are two steps. The first is prediction on the frame, and second is apply DCT. Now we all are familiar with these two terms, that we have to predict some samples. Frames are nothing but again there will be some sampled values, and on which we have to apply DCT. Its output we have to apply for the quantization. So the next step is nothing but quantization. Quantization means rounding up the data. The actual reduction can take place in this particular step. And the next is entropy calculation. Now, why the calculation of entropy is necessary? This is the main question. Entropy is able to give us the value of efficiency. And efficiency is completely related with our output. So to achieve the maximum output, we require the maximum entropy. So the conclusion of any algorithm or the conclusion of any example is nothing but the value of the entropy. So there is a necessity to calculate this entropy. Again, for the calculation of the entropy, in this there are three steps: conversion of symbols, apply zigzag pattern, apply RLE, and use XC. RLE means run length encoding, and XC means Huffman coding. So we all are familiar with this particular block, that means for the entropy calculation, because this technique is completely similar as that of the JPEG algorithm. Now we have to follow these four processes and their sub steps to calculate the MPEG output. So how on every step exactly we can calculate the output, and that we have to understand. So this is the step number one, data preparation. In that there are again two steps that we have seen. Here we have to take ratio such as 4:1:1 is present in MPEG. Now what is this? Any image can contains color in the form of RGB that we can convert into the different form YCBCR. Here Y is nothing but brightness of your image or of your video. CB is nothing but blueness in your image, that means the color blueness in your complete image. We are not talking about a part of the image. This is nothing but the calculation of our complete image. And CR is nothing but color redness, that means how much percentage of your particular input is having the red color. Now this CB, CR are nothing but C1 and C2. They are known as chrominance signal. And Y is nothing but brightness of your image, and it is known as luminance part of your image. That means the brightness of your image. So Y plus CB plus CR will give you a complete developed image. So this is the ratio of this YCBCR. So brightness is present at 4. CB is present at ratio 1:2, again CR is present at ratio 1. This is the standard format of the color combination or YCBCR ratio in your MPEG input. So this is the ratio such as 4:1:1 is present in what? Present in MPEG. Here for PAL signal it is, that means the value of Y, CB and CR. They are 352 × 288. Now what is this? Any image contains some brightness. So contains some CB, contains some CR. So how we can calculate it? This is nothing but what? Suppose this is a matrix of an image, given image of X into X or X by X matrix. Then the height and width of this particular matrix will give you an idea about the number of pixels present in the matrix. What it means by number of pixels? Every block is able to represent a pixel. So if I want an idea about the number of blocks or number of pixels in the matrix of an image, I must know the height and width so that I can take the multiplication of them to calculate the pixel or the block numbers. So suppose our matrix is of 2×2, then height is 2, width is 2. So how many blocks will be present in my matrix? 1, 2, 3, 4, 2×2. How many pixels can be present? Again, the number of blocks. Or every block can contain the different pixel, and every pixel can contain the different values. So that is the calculation of the actual pixel. The total value of pixel is a different thing, but the total amount of blocks present in the picture is nothing but what? Height into width of that particular matrix. So Y is nothing but the luminance, and its value is 352 × 288. CB and CR both are having the same proportion, so that is nothing but 176 × 144. This is the value of CB and CR. Now this is for PAL signal. Like that, there is other one more signal present in the MPEG, and that is nothing but NTSC. For that particular signal, again there are different values. They are nothing but 352, height is same, but width 240 is the width. Here also height is same. For CBCR, 176 into 120 is the width. So there is a difference between the width of the image, and that will provide us the two types of signaling, PAL and NTSC. So depend on a particular application, we can go for any type of a signal. There are 16 into 16 samples present for the luminance component. So this is nothing but what? Y component. And 8 into 8 for the chrominance. So this is nothing but C1 and C2. And most probably now it is known as what? CB and CR. Because we have taken the CB and CR as a C1 and C2. So this is the second step in the data preparation. The first step is nothing but what? Color combination, their size. So in the data preparation, there is this first step, and this is the second step, that is nothing but what? Selection or the creation of macro balls. So there are 16 into 16 samples are present for the luminance component, that means Y, and 8 into 8 for the chrominance, that is for C1 and C2, and here CB and CR are going to replace C1 and C2. So this step is nothing but creation of macro balls. And these are required to calculate the actual output with the help of the MPEG. So creation of samples is the step number one. Creation of macro balls with the help of that sample is the step number two. So what actually happened? 16 into 16 samples of luminance and 8 by 8 samples of chrominance are present in a pixel. For example, if I am going to draw any image, image size having 16 into 16 samples. So how many rows and columns will be there? Hopefully you can understand, these are the 16s and the rows will be also 16s. And hence this can be known as or can be treated as 16 by 16. So this is nothing but what? Luminance. Luminance means brightness. So obviously if I want to observe the image, I require the brightness. So to whole complete image, whatever it will be, for example, I want to display a number like 8. So this is the actual image on which I have to focus. So this is the image part on which I have to focus, and this is the image part which is nothing but can be considered as a background of the image. So simply MPEG will do what? MPEG will try to do some algorithm or do some coding on the focused part. And the unwanted part that can get removed, and which is nothing but what? Actual data. Yes, it is present in our particular image. This background is present for our particular image, but it is an unwanted part. So that part can get lost during the transmission. And at the output, we can get the focused part, most probably focused part instead of the unwanted part. And in this way, it can do the lossy compression. Now we are here. We require to select the samples which are having the luminance and chrominance. So luminance is nothing but brightness. We require the brightness to our image. So that can be provided to a complete image, that is 16 by 16. But what about chrominance? I already told you, chrominance is present with the help of CB and CR. That means blueness of image and redness of image. So this is nothing but the blueness of an image can be present in few part of the image. It cannot be present in a complete part of the image. So what are the ratio or the proportional where it is present? 8 into 8. That means not a complete image can be made up of only red color. It cannot possible that it will be made up of only blue color. So the few part, instead of 16 by 16, the 8 by 8 samples are made up of CB, the 8 by 8 samples are contains CR. So this is nothing but what? A complete image can be developed with the help of Y, CB and CR. So this is the second step where we can create the macro balls. This step is known as the creation of macro balls. So actual the step number second is data processing. Once we are getting the samples and macro balls with the help of the step number 1, which is known as the data preparation, we can move by taking the output from that step towards the data processing, which is the actual second step of your MPEG algorithm. Now, what happens in data processing? It requires to apply the motion prediction at every macro ball level. Now, we are here. We try to develop an image, and that image contains a particular number. For example, this is the output getting from the step number 1. Now, it is required to apply the motion prediction at every macro balls level. MPEG will do encoding only in the part of a motion. Only in the part which is in motion. So that we can get the actual output in terms of the video compression. The part which is stable, we can treat it as image and we can encode that particular image with the help of JPEG also. Then what is the use of MPEG? MPEG is used to encode the video, is used to encode a sequence of images, that means the motion pictures. So that a part which is in the motion form, that can be encoded, or on that part only we have to focus for the encoding. So we have to predict, because each and every macro ball is not giving us the motion value of a picture. So we have to predict a motion so that we can apply a motion prediction at every macro ball level. Here the predictive coding is applicable only that part of image where motion is present, and this is very important point that on which particular point we are going to focus in our image. So there are three types of predictions available. The first one is forward prediction, second one is backward prediction, third one is bidirectional prediction. Forward prediction can apply with the help of the previous image or the past images. Backward prediction can be applied with the help of the future or the next frames. And bidirectional prediction is nothing but the combination of both the things, and we have to apply the bidirectional prediction as per the requirement of application. So the forward prediction and backward prediction, these are depend on the frames. So first we have to understand what it means by frames. Every image is nothing but the combination of different frames. So we will try to understand the frames in MPEG. So first is the iframe. Iframe contains no temporal prediction. That means whatever the output which you are getting at the present step, take that output and try to encode the data. It can be coded independently. Yes, why? Because it is not depend on the backward prediction. That means you are the previous frames. It is also not depend on your future frames. And also it does not contain any prediction. So the actual value is nothing but the output coming from the iframes. So it can be coded independently. Then next one is nothing but T frame. It contains the forward prediction based scheme. That means what? Forward prediction means what? That value is depend on the value coming from the back frames or the previous frames. And the next one is B frame. Future predictive based. That means what? The value is depend on the future frames prediction. And I and P frame based. Indirectly what? Both the frames and their output, it will contains the output depends on I as well as P frame. So first of all, the I frame, current value, so independently coded. P frame, it based on the forward prediction, that means the previous value dependent. And B is nothing but the combination of I and P frame. So with the help of I, P, B, this is nothing but the frames in the MPEG. With the help of the values getting from this particular frames, we have to encode, or we have to predict actually the motion prediction so that we can encode a particular video. So here is algorithm or this output we can use where? we can use that particular output in forward prediction, in backward prediction, and in bidirectional prediction. So with the help of these three frames, we can do the motion prediction, that means the data processing. Now, the next part is, once we have the idea about I, P, B frames present in a particular input, we can calculate the GOP. Now, what it means by GOP, group of pictures. It indicates set of two between two I frames. Now, what it means exactly? For example, if your particular input is nothing but the development of I, P, 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 again I, again B, again I, again P, again I, then I, this is nothing but, for example, development of your image, or we can say multiple image, single image, or indirectly the input for your MPEG, then this is nothing but the frame structure, that is a combination of IPB. Then how we can calculate the GOP? It indicates the set of two between what? Between two I frames. So from this I to the next I. What is this? Set of two I. And in between that, how many frames are there? 3P. After that, again, this is the new I. This is the next I. So set of these two I. And what it in between? B is present, B frame is present. So B frame is nothing but what? Group of frame in between these two I. Again, in between these two I, what is present? The different P frame. So P frame is nothing but the group of frame which is present in between two I. After that, in between these two I is nothing but what? Between two I. So I, this can be a single group, this can be a single group, or this can be a single group. So in between two I, whenever something is present, or the group of I, or the group of any frame of I, B, or P, that is nothing but known as the GOP. And such kind of GOP are much more useful for the motion prediction. So that we can predict a motion of a picture. So the development of frame is necessary so that we can calculate the GOP. And then we can go for the forward prediction, backward prediction, bidirectional prediction to calculate the motion prediction. Motion prediction is useful for the selection of a motion part in a particular input so that we can encode that part. The next step is, we have to apply DCT. On what? On the require to remove the high frequency component. Why to apply the DCT? For removing high frequency component, HF component. We have to apply DCT on what? On 8 into 8 blocks. So 8 by 8 blocks, which are able to give us some coefficients. How many coefficients they are able to give us? 64 coefficient. So on that particular coefficient, we require to apply the DCT to remove the high frequency coefficient. That means indirectly we have to focus on the lower frequency coefficient. And next one is quantization. Apply this process on a frequency domain coefficient. Now quantization is nothing but what? Rounding up the sampled value to reduce the data in your input. Now, we have to apply this particular process to reduce a data, but with the help of what, or on which we have to do this process? On frequency domain coefficient. Now, these are nothing but what? Value, sampled value, which we can get from the matrices. And to the quantization, who will provide the value? DCT algorithm output are nothing but the input for the quantization process. So we have to apply the process on the frequency domain coefficient only. This play an important role to store the minimum data in a video. Minimum data storing means what? Already we tried to remove the high frequency component with the help of DCT. So that what we can say, we can save the data space to store a video. After that, we try to do the process of quantization, which is nothing but what the actual reduction of a process, in which we can apply this process on a frequency domain coefficient. Again, we try to focus on the lower frequency so that with the help of these two processes, we can store a minimum data. That means here actually we can reduce the data. So it plays an important role for what? For storing the minimum data in a particular video. Now, the step number 4 for the MPEG algorithm, that is nothing but what? Entropy coding. I already told you why the entropy is necessary to calculate the efficiency of your output and which will be the aim from any algorithm. Now, to find out the entropy, there are again few steps. First is convert two-dimensional symbols into one-dimensional symbols. So, indirectly conversion of 2x2 matrices into 1x1 matrices. Then second is apply zigzag pattern on the coefficient. Calculation of the entropy we have to do in this particular step with the help of selection of position of coefficient. And how can we select the position at which particular step, which position value I have to use from the given matrices. For example, we have already discussed we can develop an micro balls having the 16x16 value of a matrix. So, for example, this is nothing but a given matrices. Then we have to apply a zigzag pattern. So, how can we apply the zigzag pattern? This is nothing but what? Start from this end here. Start from this end here. So, like that, we have to go and we have to use the zigzag pattern for the selection of the coefficient. In this process, you can understand, we try to remove the unwanted data. That means what? We are not going to use such kind of samples or the pixels. Now the zigzag pattern we all know. This is nothing but what is zigzag pattern. But we can apply the zigzag pattern by observing the matrices. Not necessary that always my matrix will be like this. That means the size of the matrix can vary when your input will get vary. So that pattern where we can apply or the pattern of the focused image can be different, but how to apply the pattern to select the coefficient, that is nothing but what? Zigzag pattern, and it is fixed. Now the next one is use of RLE for 1D pattern. 1D pattern means one dimensional pattern. You are getting some output. Now what it means by RLE? 0 0 0 0 1 1 1. Now how many bits are there? Total 7 bits. So run length encoding will give me what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times. Then 1, how many times? 1, 2, 3, 3 times. So RLE will give me the output in the compressed format. It will never lose the actual data. It will try to reduce the size of the data. So use of RLE will play very important role for the process of quantization. Now 0, 4, 1, 3, that means what? 4 times 0 comes 4 times. 1 comes or appears 3 times. So at the part of the decoding, I am getting actual input which I am going to provide to the algorithm. Then last step is nothing but apply Huffman coding. We all know that calculation of entropy is possible with the help of some lossless algorithm techniques. Actually, it can be possible with the help of lossy algorithm also, but already the entropy value we required what? Maximum. Why? Because entropy is nothing but the actual output of your algorithm, and that you required maximum, and that can be possible using the lossless technique. This is the simple thing why we are going for the RLE and Huffman coding, because these are nothing but what? Lossless technique. Lossless means the input data after encoding, you are getting some output, and that output after decoding, you are getting exactly same as that of the input. That means no loss in the transmission in the form of the compression. So here, if I want the maximum efficiency, I must have to go for what? The lossless technology, and that are nothing but what? RLE and Huffman coding. And hence, at the end of your MPEG algorithm also, like the JPEG, we have to go for RLE and Huffman coding for the different type of coefficients. So this is nothing but what? The actual steps which we require to calculate the MPEG algorithm. So In this particular video lecture, what we have studied, the first step of data development, in which formation of samples, creation of macropoles, that means what? YCBCR and its ratio, and creation of macropoles means what? 16 by 16 sample formatting for the Y and 8 by 8 sample formatting for the CBCR. After that, its output we have to apply for the data processing unit. Here we have to do the prediction on the frames. Frames, three types of frames are there, I, B, P. And then after predicting the frames, we have to apply DCT on them. That output we have to go to apply for the quantization. Here the process of the quantization, the high frequency components, after removing them, we have to apply this process on the frequency domain coefficients. And last one is nothing but the calculation of entropy, where we have to convert the output from 2D to 1D. Indirectly, the output must be in the one dimensional format. Then we have to apply the zigzag pattern, and finally apply RLE and HC. These are nothing but the lossless technique to the calculation of the entropy, which will give us the better result of an MPEG algorithm. So this is the actual process of MPEG algorithm, and this question is frequently asked for the 10 marks. So in this way, we have to elaborate the answer. Thank you.